Hello students, in this video we'll be going through a few theorems of parallelogram. We have in our previous two videos we have covered theorem 1 and theorem 8.2 and theorem 8.3. In this video we'll be covering the remaining theorems on parallelogram. So the first theorem is theorem 8.4, which says that in a parallelogram opposite angles are equal. And to prove that, we have been given a parallelogram ABCD and asked to prove angle B is equal to angle D. Angle B is equal to angle D. So for that, once again, what we'll try to do is we'll try to get these two triangles congruent to each other. That is triangle ABC shown congruent to triangle CDA. Once we get the two triangles congruent to each other, we can say by CPCT angle B is equal to angle D. Let's begin. In triangle ABC and triangle CDA, we have angle BAC equal to this angle BAC equal to angle DCA. Okay, this would be alternate interior angles, and then we have AC equal to AC, which is the common side, followed by now we've got this angle equal to this angle, so this one equal to this one. We can also show this one equal to this one. So angle BCA equal to angle DAC. Once again, alternate interior angles. So we can say, therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA by angle side angle congruence rule. And once we have proved that these two triangles are congruent, we can say angle B is equal to angle D by CPCT. So that's how we get we prove the theorem 8.4. The next theorem, 8.5, says that if in a quadrilateral each pair of opposite angles is equal, then it is a parallelogram. Okay, in other words, what it says that, let's say in this is a quadrilateral, and if angle B is equal to angle D and angle A is equal to angle C, okay, then we can say that quadrilateral ABCD, cancel this part. What this theorem says is, if let's say this is a quadrilateral, and in this quadrilateral we have angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D, then it says then this quadrilateral ABCD becomes a parallelogram. That is what it is. So this is just the opposite or the reverse of what we did in theorem 8.4, which says that if this is a parallelogram, then in case of the parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. So in other words, this is just discussing the property of a parallelogram, that opposite angles are equal in a parallelogram. So if sometimes you'll be given a parallelogram, you have to understand that the opposite angles of that parallelogram will be equal, and sometimes you're given that opposite angles are equal of a quadrilateral, then from there you must deduce the fact that this is a parallelogram. The next theorem, 8.6, says the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. What it's trying to say is this AC and BD, okay, they cut each other into equal parts, such that we will get AO equal to CO and BO will be equal to DO. That is what it means by bisecting. So this line cuts, so in other words, you can say AC, okay, bisects DB, or you can say DB bisects AC. Both hold true because they divide each other into equal parts. That is theorem 8.6, a property of a parallelogram, that the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Which are the diagonals, by the way? AC and BD are the diagonals. So diagonal, there are two diagonals in this figure and they are AC and BD, and they bisect each other, so that they cut each other into equal parts. According to the next theorem, 8.7, if the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. In other words, if there is a quadrilateral, let's say quadrilateral ABCD, and in that quadrilateral you have been given that there are diagonals, there are two diagonals of that quadrilateral, that diagonals are AC and BD, and they bisect each other, okay, AC bisects BD, such that AO equal to CO and BO equal to DO. In such a case, it says that quadrilateral, then quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. By the way, this is the short form for writing a parallelogram, but you rather write the full form, that is parallelogram. Okay, so just a converse of theorem 8.6, which says in a parallelogram diagonals bisect each other. This one says that we have been given a quadrilateral in which the diagonals bisect each other. When the diagonals bisect each other in a quadrilateral, then that quadrilateral becomes a parallelogram. According to the last theorem that we will cover in this video, the theorem 8.8 says a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel, which in other words says that if in a quadrilateral, let's say ABCD, in this figure AB is equal to DC and AB is parallel to DC, then quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Another property of quadrilateral, which tells us that if a pair of opposite sides are parallel and equal, then this quadrilateral becomes a parallelogram. So we've covered all the properties of a parallelogram through these theorems. If you have liked watching this video, please click on the like button, share it with your friends and classmates. Please subscribe to the channel and do not forget to click on the bell icon to receive notification whenever a new video is posted. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.